write two more attempt. Okay, so June 19 and December 19 for these two examination. June 19 and
December
19 for these two examination, Finance Act 18 is applicable. If you go, if you fail in December 19, then you will write June 20. For June 20, you have to study Finance Act 2019, which will be different than this act. Okay, syllabus will change, and therefore we say direct tax and indirect tax syllabus changes every year. Direct tax changes every year, indirect tax changes every month. Okay, and any syllabus which has changed 6 months earlier than your exam. Okay, so if you are writing December attempt, so any amendment taken place before June is applicable in your exam. Okay, so right now whatever amendments are happening in the industry, okay, you should keep focus on it, because any amendment which will take up to May or June, okay, will become applicable to December attempt. Hello?
Yes.
June attempt, you don't have to worry, because whatever amendment was supposed to take place up to December has already taken place. So your syllabus is frozen now. Okay? Your syllabus is fixed. So point number four, then we have to discuss notifications. Sometime government issues notifications. Government has power to issue notification. Okay, and who will issue notification? Central? I should not write state government. I told you logic behind it. Because this act is governed by? So Maharashtra government cannot pass notification about income tax. Okay, next, fifth. Then there will be circulars. All trade notices. This is the issue in case of confusion, to clarify certain point, and this is issued by CBDT. CBDT, you already know who is CBDT, so I don't have to speak more about it. Six, after reading all these things, to understand this law in a better manner, okay, so you are studying the same sections at intermediate and same sections will be there at CMA final. Okay, so what is the difference between intermediate and final? Intermediate level, you will study only sections. CMA final, you will study section along with Supreme Court and High Court case laws. Okay, so you will study practical cases. Okay, in this case this has happened, in that case this has happened, in L&T this has happened, in Reliance this has happened. Okay, through section, so you will have better understanding of sections through case law. When we put case law knowledge into you, we call you as expert. Okay, when we put only sections in your mind, we say you are having working knowledge. So there are two levels of knowledge, working knowledge and expert knowledge. What is the difference between working to expert knowledge? Only case laws. Because when Supreme Court gives judgment, they apply everything possible relating to that particular section. Okay? Alright? And therefore, finally we have to understand judicial pronouncement, which is the CMA final. But to understand income tax law, you need to understand judicial pronouncement. Alternatively, you call it as case law. Judicial pronouncement is known as case law. Who will issue case law? So there are three authorities, ITAT. You understand ITAT? Now? Okay. Income tax appellate tribunal, then High Court, and then how many Supreme Courts we have? One. Therefore it is Supreme. Alternatively, Supreme Court is known as Apex Court. APEX. Apex means Supreme. Okay, so Apex Court or Supreme Court. High Court will be there in majority all states. Goa does not have, so Goa has common High Court, and that is Maharashtra. Okay, Bombay High Court is there for Goa and Maharashtra. You understood? So this is income tax law. Take a note of it.